lady they call the Gypsy. She can look in the future and drive away all your fears.
After the war changed, after the Second World War, I'd say Coney Island changed. I personally feel. Prior to the World War, Coney Island was the thing. Coney Island was it. Because you can get here for 5 cents. From all over, from Queens, from Manhattan, from the Bronx, all over.
We used to come here and pay 5 cents for a subway. We used to come here with a quarter. We were like millionaires. Because all the rides and all the things were about 5 cents. We used to go to Nathan's and buy Frankfurters for 5 cents. So if you had a quarter, you was rich. We used to sleep on the sand all night long. Movie stars used to be working all around these places. All these places, Luna Park, everything, Cary Grant, Jimmy Durante, all the famous people that you ever seen used to come here in tuxedos.
We used to go to the beach, hundreds of thousands of people on the beach.
Hundreds of thousands.
Always crowded.
You had to walk over the blankets just to get to the water. That's how jammed it used to be.
You came to Coney Island for 5 cents on the subway. 5 cents was the hot dog. Nathan's used to work with Feldman's.
It's great for the kids. They love it. You know, it just, the rides are all kind of low key, nothing too scary.
It has a lot of nice memories for me here. When I started to get 14, 15, under the boardwalk was a very, very nice and revealing place. And a lot of happy memories there.
Someday.
Luna Park. Luna Park is across the street from the Cyclone. That was Luna Park, was the wonder of the world. They had, well, her brother was a diving champion, and he used to dive from maybe as high as that rooftop over there.
Big tank, a big water
tank. And
they
used to have a water tank on the sidewalk, and he used to dive from there into the tank. Her brother Frank too.
He was a swimming champ, a city swimming champ years ago.
I don't know, it reminds me of old New York, and old New York was just really special. It wouldn't have the brass Donald Trump buildings or anything like that. If you see like the old movies, they're brick buildings. It has a lot of, I don't know what the word is, a culture that we don't see anymore here. So Coney Island reminds me of that.
That's interesting. It's a mixture of urban, you know, and the beach. That's kind of unusual. And there's so many different people here. It's, you know, as much as people say New York is a melting pot, Coney Island is more so, I think.
You could say it's on the beach, but the beach is almost a small part of it. It's just, it's almost like a carnival. You know, there's people on the boardwalk, you know, everybody's walking, there's people dancing, there's musicians, there's puppet shows, there's games, there's rides. It's, you know, an amusement park and a beach, but it has this urban flavor to it.
Steeplechase Park. I think you used to go in there for a quarter, and they had maybe 10, 15 rides, all kind of different things, you know? You know, I used to go in the cars, your bumpy cars, you bang each other, you know. We used to get a big kick out of that, the kids, you know.
I was here a few weeks ago playing the games. I won 3 stuffed animals, and it's just a great place to be.